What's up, guys? It's Kreayshawn, and you're watching Billboard. Hey, bitch, do you really, really, really want to go hard? Go in the crib, till you step on this credit card. And take the car, do circles in the parking lot. Scream at the top of our lungs like la la la. Somethin Bout Kreay basically came from like a situation where like this guy was like obsessed with me kinda, and like my homie was like, damn, there's just Somethin Bout Kreay. He's like, oh my god, that's perfect, cause like, you know, people are very passionate about me, whether they're like, oh, I love Kreayshawn, she's the best, or it's like, oh, I hate Kreayshawn, she's the worst. So it's always something about me that makes people feel like a certain way. There was a song dedicated to myself on the album, Blase Blase would be that song. It's about like how basically concentrate on what you want to do and like get your money, like fuck the haters, blah blah blah, like that type of thing. When I was writing that song, I was definitely like showing off like to myself. It's my song, Chippy on the beat, so you know. Chuk Chuk Tari is the title's in Hindi. And my homegirl Chippy Nonstop, who's on the song, translated. And it means the stars are hiding. The song's like super bilingual. We have like Russian and the hook is in Hindi. And it was just a fun song and it's like Chicago house inspired. And it was just cool to have a song with my homegirl Chippy on the album. Gucci Gucci is it's just like the crazy legendary song. Like sometimes I'll go on YouTube and be like, what, 38 million views? Like that's ridiculous, it's so crazy. And it's like, you know, you do the whole show and like everybody's waiting at the end to like sing the whole Gucci Gucci song because everyone knows it by heart. It's summertime and your bitch is on my mind. It's summertime and your bitch is on my mind. Summertime, we recorded around like the same time as Gucci Gucci. Me and V Nasty did the song. Me and her have been friends forever, so definitely made that song in like a very chill like environment, and there wasn't like a lot of pressure, and I think that's why the song just flows a lot better, because like there wasn't a lot of pressure and we're just hanging out in the studio. Left Eye is like the crazy revenge song for like cheating, and like as you know, like R.I.P. Left Eye. Back in the day, like, you know, she set her husband's clothes on fire. There's this one line on there where I'm like, you know, I'm gonna cut your dick off. So like every time I do a show, like me and my hype man, like I'll chase him around the stage and I'm like, I'm gonna cut your dick off, it's cheat on me. And like, I'll be like, how many girls like been cheated on before? They're like, ah, I'm like, cut his fucking dick off. Like. Like It or Love It is with Kid Cudi, and it's very punk inspired, and he was just in the studio because he's good friends with Jean-Baptiste, who worked with me throughout the whole album. It was just crazy like for us to get together and do like a punk inspired song, because like you wouldn't think of that with like two rappers going in. That song kind of makes the album like show that every song is different, you know? Like if there wasn't that song, like maybe like people wouldn't understand when I say like every song is inspired by a different genre of music. So I think like that song is like really, really important. Kreayshawnics was like, it was like such a battle, because like when I was doing that song, like it's so hard to like you can't top like the old school style. It was crazy because one of JJ Fad's daughters hit me up on Twitter, and I was like, oh my god, like, you know, like they're legendary, like that's like a group that like paved the way, you know what I'm saying, for people, like for girls to even like be into rap music. So I was like, yeah, like your mom's like an inspiration. She's like, oh my god, that's so cool. So it's like cool to have that connection like with the song. BFF is like one of my favorite songs on the album. It's just like about best friends, and I always have like really intense best friend relationships, and like they just go to shit. Like, so basically that's what it's about. And I got in the booth and like we listened to the beat and I was like, oh my god, like we should make like a super like R&B cheesy song to this. And then like I got in the booth and like they had like the auto tune, and like when you have the auto tune on your voice, you just get so into like just listening to yourself. And so like I basically like freestyled that song. Twerkin' is the song produced by Diplo, and he's actually featured on it, and we have Sissy Melby on it. We recorded my part, and that we did that like that second. I was like, I already know what I want to do this, you know? So we recorded it instantly, and then I was like, is there still something missing? And like I was like, we need to get another person on the song. And the song is so busy, like the beat is really busy. So it's like finding the right part to put it on. And Sissy Melby, he's from New Orleans, but he was in Oakland recording his album. So I went up to Oakland and I did a song with him and I got the vocals for Twerkin'. And it was crazy because he was like super nervous to meet me. And I'm like, why are you nervous? Like, you know? And he said that I can twerk and that he can see it in my eyes. Like I got the twerk in my eyes, he said, so. It's pretty cool to hear that. I'm hungry for this money. Call me Kreay Hefner, playboy. Working with 2 Chainz, we had previously did a song on his mixtape. I knew that I had to get him on the album because I've worked with him before, and like we had such like a cool combo because he's like really, really tall and like crazy dreads, and I'm like really, really short, with like little short hair, and like I don't know, it's just like such a cool comparison. We shot the music video to Breakfast in Atlanta. Everything was kind of like 80s inspired. Like I wanted like all the outfits and the pajamas to be like silk one pieces. And it's weird because like when I first started doing shows, like I wanted to only perform in pajamas. And that was gonna be like my signature, was like performing in pajamas and coming out with pillows and blankets every show. But it didn't really work because like I don't know why I would do that anyway. So it was really cool to like get that out on Breakfast. Go Hard was the first song that I worked on when I got into like the album mode. Sometimes you hear a beat and then you have to go home with it for a couple days, and sometimes you go into the studio and you hear a beat and then you're like done in like an hour or two. And Go Hard was definitely one of those songs. People always hit me up and be like, stealing my stepdad's credit card. It's so real. Like, I've had so many stepdads my whole life, and I feel like a lot of people go through like stepdad phase and like, steal his credit card, fuck it, you know? The Ruler was really fun to work on because it's like, it's got so many like verses. It's like full of words. My mom like would listen to a lot of Slick Rick, so I thought it was really cool to have like a hook like dedicated to Slick Rick. Yeah, the song is just super funny. I think like that song really like is like painting a mental image type of thing. Like every time I say something, it's like you gotta picture it in your head. Love House is like crazy. I sang on it. Like it's just like a really passionate song lyric wise. And then like for me, it's like means a lot to me because like I got over my fear of singing, but then I don't ever want to perform it. It's gonna be like the song, like I get off stage and like everyone's like, Love House, Love House, Love House. I'm come on, like, sorry guys, I'm not okay. And then I'll like, you know, like I'll probably like sing it with like the track behind me. And that's probably how it'll happen. I don't know, like maybe I'll take voice lessons and then my next album will be all R&B.